First of all, congratulations on your win. Tell us a little bit about the experience as a whole and what you've taken away from it.
Oh, the experience, it was a fantastic journey. It was phenomenal. I would honestly recommend it to anybody. It's been a roller coaster of a ride. And I'm going to take away with it lasting friendships, I think, is the main thing. And a whole new aspect of myself. I just can't believe, you know, when you put your mind to something, what you can achieve. It's been incredible.
Excellent. And how are you feeling at the time that your name was called during Saturday night's show? And reflecting back on it, how are you feeling now? Is it any different?
It's a little bit different. Looking back, I honestly was in disbelief. I could not imagine. I couldn't believe it. It was very unreal. And now, I guess it's sinking in a little bit because I've been so busy today. It's sort of, people have been forcing me to sort of get really used to the idea, you know. I've been having interviews all day, etc. But I've seen Miss Gibraltar in the past, and to me, they've always been, you know, tall, beautiful, elegant women, and now, you know, I'm one of them too, which is fantastic because now younger girls can look up to me and think, see, wow, another tall, elegant, beautiful woman, but who also has a beautiful personality on the inside as well, which is what I want to try to gain from this as well.
And what's next for Miss Gibraltar 2013? What are the sort of salient matters and aspects of the role that you're hoping to put across?
The main thing, even before the competition, I'd always wanted to sort of work more alongside charities and do a lot of volunteering work. And I sort of want to put that across a bit more as well now. You know, now I want to try to use my newfound fame or whatever you want to call it to put those names out there of charities that are in need of the publication and in need of the help, you know, just to sort of get the community to work along with each other a little bit more. And as well as that, I also just want to be, you know, an inspiration. I want to be a really good role model to our youth.
Excellent. Now, could you tell us a little bit about yourself and your background?
Myself, you know, most importantly, I really just want people to know that I am one of the most down-to-earth, fun-loving, animal-loving freak. You know, there is, you know, I am not intimidating. I don't want people to be scared to come up and talk to me, you know. I am here for anybody. I want to give young girls advice and tips, whatever it may be, and I just want to put across, you know, stick to what you believe in and stay in education, importantly as well, and just be yourself always, always.
And why did you choose to enter Miss Gibraltar 2013?
Why did I choose to be Miss Gibraltar? Well, I think because I am such a down-to-earth, just crazy personality that I think it would have been really good for people to see that in, you know, in a role model, that someone is just kind and warm and loving, you know. I just wanted to be that person that people could look up to.
And with regards to Miss Gibraltar work and Miss World, what's next for you?
What's next? So I've just been given my diary for the next couple of months, and I am a busy bee. But it's going to be extremely exciting. So I'm going to have a lot of training, you know, for the Miss World, which is the main thing we're going to focus on now. So end of August is when they'll be sending me off. So until then, I'll just be working really hard for that, towards that.
Excellent. And finally, what does it mean to you to be the first winner of Moroccan descent, and how has your community sort of reacted to it?
Oh, you have no idea. It's been overwhelming. I cannot believe the support that I've been getting, you know, not just from my Moroccan community, but, you know, the whole of Gibraltar as a whole. Everybody is really proud and really excited. And I just hope that I've started, you know, a new era. You know, I just hope that young girls who are Gibraltarians of Moroccan descent, just like me, who thought that maybe they couldn't stand the chance, or maybe they didn't have the right, or whatever it may be, to do enter the pageant. You know, it's a lot of fun. You're going to gain lots of confidence. And I just, you know, I just want to sort of put out there that if you believe in something, just do it, regardless of what other people tell you. Don't let anybody stop you.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much for speaking to us.
Thank you very much. Thanks.